Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. This is the continuation of the previous tutorial where we were discussing about the Quicksort program. So in that program, we took the first element as the pivot element and we saw how we can arrange the number in the ascending order as well as descending order. Now we will see how to take the last element as the pivot and arrange the number in the ascending as well as descending order. So first, here we can see, here while taking the pivot, now I need to take the last element as the pivot. So here I need to write last. So next, left will be from first and right will be last minus 1. That's because here we can see, now here this is the pivot element. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this will be my left value, right? And this will be right. So left is 0, that's nothing but the first value, and right is 4. So this will be my last value. Okay, so last minus 1. Next, this condition all are same. Here this condition is for descending order because I changed the sign. Okay, so that's why it will print the numbers in the descending order. So all the condition are same, but here in this line where right value become smaller than left, then it will execute break and it will come out of the loop and it will execute this line. That is, we are swapping the pivot element to its original position. So for that, in the previous tutorial, when we took the first element as the pivot, we swapped the first element as well as the value present in the right index. So but here we need to swap the pivot element as well as the value present in the left index. Okay, so here I need to change it to left. Here also left. Okay, and here what is pivot? Pivot is nothing but list one of last, right? So here last. Okay, here we are swapping the element present in the left index as well as the element present in the last index, or we can say the pivot element. Okay, why I didn't take pivot here? Because we want to change the value in the list itself. Okay, so if I mention pivot here, it won't swap the number to list. I want to arrange the number in the list, that's why I need to take like this. Okay, here instead of right, I need to return left. So just remember, when you take the last element as the pivot, you need to swap pivot element with the left index value. But if you take the first element, then you need to swap the value with right index value. Okay, just that difference. Then everything is same. No need to change anything in this function and this. Okay, so now I'll save this and run this. So here we can see numbers in the descending order. Okay, so this is about how we can take the last element as pivot and we can arrange the number. So next, if I want to take the random element as the pivot, then how to do that? So for that, here to generate the random index, I'll use random module. So first I'll import that. Okay, import random. We need to write this beginning of the program. Next, here what I'll do is, so here we are generating a random index. Okay, and we'll take the value present in that random index as pivot. So what I'll do is, I'll take one variable called r index, that means random index. Okay, so here I'll use random, that is the module name. Function is rand int. Okay, so next, here I'll mention from first to last. All right, so this function will generate a random index from first to last. That's nothing but if 6 elements are there from 0 to 5, it can be anything. Okay, it will randomly generate that. Okay, so we got an index of that element. Now what I'll do is, whatever the element present in that random index, I'll copy that to last index. Okay, last position, I'll place that last position. So no need of changing anything in the code, just we are swapping the value present in the random index and the value present in the last index. So you can do that like this: list one of r index, list one of last. Okay, if you ask why you are copying to the last, we already have this code where the pivot element is last element. Okay, that's why I am copying it to last place. Alright, so now I'll take the last element as the pivot, that is the element which was present in the random index. Then I'll continue the same thing. Okay, we can see the numbers in the descending order. So if I change the numbers here we can see the numbers. If I take 17 here we can see. Okay, so numbers are in the descending order. So here what I did is actually, okay, so these are the index. Okay, in the program I use the random function, so that will give a random index. Okay, it can be 3, 1, 5, anything. So if suppose I take the random index is 3, then so random index will be 3. Now what I'll do is, whatever the value present in this index, I'll copy that to last position. So I'll swap the 14 and 12. So here 12 comes here, 14 will go here. Okay, now the pivot element is present at last. Now I'll do the same procedure to sort them, so it will make the program easier. That's why. Okay, I'll copy the whatever the value present in the random index to last place, or you can place that to first position also. Okay, so this is how we can generate a random index and we can take a random element as the pivot element. So next is median of three values. Okay, so here what I'll do is, we will use the median function itself. So to use that, we need to import the statistics module. So okay, so next, I don't want this random thing, right? So what I'll do is, to find out the median of three values, I need three values. Okay, the first one is the value present in the first index, and the value present in the last index, and the value present in the middle index. So first, the value present in the first index I'll take as low. Okay, so I'll take list one of first, whatever the value present in the zeroth index. Okay, next here I'll take the value present in the last index as high. So here I'll take list one of last. Okay, it will give the last element. So now I want middle. So middle, for that I'll take like this: first plus last, truncated division 2. Okay, so this is the index. Okay, these are the values, but here I took the middle index. But while taking the median function, I'll take list one of mid. Okay, so here next line is pivot value. I'll take a variable called pivot value. Okay, here I'll take statistics dot median, so module name dot function name. Okay, so here we need to give in the list form. Here it will take only one argument, okay, that is list. So here I need to mention first as low. Okay, next middle value, so list one of middle, because here we took index, right? That's why here I want value, that's why list one of middle. Next here high. Okay, so whatever the value it will give, it will be stored in this pivot value. So it will give the pivot value, no, median of these three value. Okay, so now I want its index, because I want to copy that value to last index. Okay, so for that I need its index. So for that, what I need to do is, I'll use if else conditional statement. Okay, because the index can be 3, okay? It can be either 0th index or the last index or the middle index, right? The index of pivot value can be anything. So index of this value can be these 3. So I'll take this if else conditional statement to find out that. So here, if, so whatever the pivot value I got, if that is equal to the low, then p index, so the that value index will be first. Okay, so if I got the median of these 3 value, that if the median is low, then that means the value present in the 0th index. We know that index, right? So I return that. I took p index will be first. Elif, if the value is equal to high, that means p index is, so here should be if elif, okay? Okay, is equal to last, all right? And now next, last, if both these are false, then p index is middle. Okay, so here, so from this median function I'll get the pivot value, but I want to place that in the last index. So for that I need the index of that pivot value. So for that I'm doing this, I'm comparing that value with the low, high and the next value, middle value. So if any one of those is true, then I know the index. Okay, from this I'll get the index. So next what I'll do is I'll copy that to last position. So I'll swap the value present in the last index and p index. Okay, okay, so now I copied the value to the last index. Now I'll take that value present in the last as pivot and I'll continue this same process. Okay, so if I now execute this, so here we can see the values in the descending order. Okay, so that's it for now guys. So here we took the first element as pivot, last element as pivot, random element as pivot, as well as median of 3 values as pivot value. So we arrange the number in the ascending order as well as descending order. Now you may have other ideas to write this program. So if you have any other ideas, then don't forget to comment below. And if you have any easy method or any other method, don't forget to comment below. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.